My name is Yu Long. So now I want to introduce national budget in terms of Malaysia. In Malaysia, federal budget are presented annually by the government of Malaysia and identify purpose, government revenue and spending, and forecast economy condition for the upcoming year, and its fiscal policy for the forward years.
Introduce about how the budget can affect in consumption. The first point is GST will not be introduced because it is cancellation. The second point is increase of tax relief to 6,000 for medical expenses including fertility treatment. The third point is to reduce supply overhang of condominiums apartment of 8.3 billion governments will lower threshold on high-rise property price in urban area for foreign ownership from 1 million to 600,000 in 2020.
Hi, I'm Dr. Xuan. Today, I want to discuss the comparing budget 2018 and 2019. Now, this is the three main types. First is institutional reforms, well-being and promotion. The strategy to recapture Malaysia economic tiger status is strengthening fiscal management. Besides that, it also restructure and strategize government debt as well as increase government revenue. Next, the tiger status can ensure welfare and quality life to Malaysian by increasing job opportunities and bank marketability. The government can also initiate new economic power and great opportunity to face good global challenge. Now is the comparison national budget of 2017 and 2018. Budget 2018 is focused on the theme proposal with inclusive economy, balancing duniawi and akhrawi excellence to better the lives of the rakyat towards TN50 aspiration, which is not different from budget 2017. That is allocating growth, ensuring fiscal prudence, and changing well-being to Malaysia's citizen. Other than that, it is a good news for aspiring parents. In budget 2018, all children born between 1st January 2018 to 2020 will be eligible for an initial saving fund of RM200 in PNB Unit Trust Scheme. Also, the government is proposing an increase of maternity leave to 19 days for employees in the private sector.
Hi, Mr. Tai, and my name is Teo Keng. I'm group leader for this group. And now, an introduction for the impact of the expenditure. Government expenditure can divide for two. One is spending, one is expenditure. And that is all government consumption. That can include investment, transport payment, subsidy, or otherwise. And now, in national income accounting, the acquisition by government of goods and service of common use to directly certain the individual or collective need of the community is classic a government financial consumption expenditure. Government acquisition of goods and service internals to create future benefits such as intra-government investment or research spending is classed as government investment. These two types of government spending. One is final consumption and gross capital information together constitute one of the major components of gross domestic product. And government spending can be financial by government borrowing and taxes. Chance in government spending is a major component of fiscal policy used to stabilize the macroeconomic business cycle. This high possibility that the rise in taxes will negate the impact of rising government spending, which will leave aggregate demand uncharged. However, it is impossible that increased spending and rise in tax could lead to an increase the GDP.
And the investment is government and financial institutions to introduce rent-to-owns RTO financing scheme. Up to $10 billion will be provided by the financial institution. The second point is government to provide investment package of $1 billion a year for FIRE to attract Fortune 500 firms in high-tech manufacturing creative economy sector. The third point is company implementing solar leasing activity can get income tax exemption of 17% for up to net is government to get Malaysia to become used to making digital payments through e-wallets. The government will credit 30 ringgit into the e-wallet of every Malaysian who are 18 and above and earn less than 100,000 a year. The second point is 10-year tax exemptions for electronics sector then shift toward N5G and Industry 4.0.
So this is the comparison between year 2018 and 2019. The unemployment rate is 3.36% increased to 3.4%. When minimum salary increase, people tend to work, unemployment rate decrease. When government invest in firms will increase, firms production will increase, labor needed increase, unemployment will decrease. When production will increase, price decrease and inflation will decrease. Money supply decrease and inflation will decrease. Now I would like to explain Malaysia unemployed person. The unemployment rate in Malaysia ticked down to 3.2% in November 2019 from 3.3% in the same month the previous year. The number of unemployed fell 0.4% from a year earlier to 513,900. While employment lost 2.5% to 15.31 million. Also, the labor force grew 2.4% to 15.83 million. On a seasonally adjusted basis, the jobless rate edged out to 3.3% in November from 3.2% in October. So now I want to talk about Malaysia employed person. The number of employed persons in Malaysia increased in November 2019. Employed persons in Malaysia averaged about 12,000 from 1985 until 2019, reaching an all-time high of 15,315 in November of 2019 and a record low of 5,624 in December of 1985.
Next is CPI. Consumer Price Index reflects change in the cost of the average consumer of acquiring a basket of goods and services that may be fixed or change at specific intervals such as yearly. CPI in 2018. Consumer Price Index for Malaysia was 120.7 index. Consumer Price Index of Malaysia increased from 22.9 index in 1969 to 100.7 index in 2018, growing at an average annual rate of 3.48%.
And now I am introduced for forecast outcome to inflation and employment of budget 20 and 20 years. In 20 and 20s, government plans to create 735,000 jobs in 5 years. So government want to plan 6.5 million over 5 years for 350k new jobs for Malaysia, create 130k forever worker. Other than this, inflation is forecast to stay low in 2020 at 2.0%, and labour market are expected to stable with unemployment rate at 3.3% through investment support for SME and export. And this is the highlight to 2020 budget. In my conclusion of budget, national budget of Malaysia, I think this is very important to help the government and the citizen to build the facility, subsidy or what, because it will help more people increase their salary and other this. In budget of 2020, the employment rate will be increased because the salary of for minimum is from 900 increased to 1,200. So the employment rate will be increased. This is my conclusion.
My conclusion is a strong economy is a clear sign of development and implementation of policy for making a better use of natural resources as well as human resources which result in future growth and prosperity. Thank you.
So the conclusion for the budget policy is these strong policies will be provide as best weapons against the effects for future problems. Some of those policies will refine the past reforms. The challenge to improve the economic growth will find solutions. That's all for my conclusion.